Very nice. Very good. It is Ruskin Bond is the answer. Okay. Now here, once again, we have not understood any doubts about the Dust of Snow poem. What are the elements of nature in this? Listen to the question first. What are the elements of nature in the poem Dust of Snow? Karthik, stand up. Elements of nature. The elements of nature in Dust of Snow. Mehul, wake up. And snow. Very nice. Very good. Right. And of course here, what was the poet's experience, Vansh? What was the poet's experience? Yes, in this poem, Dust of Snow. Yes. The snow, some snow fell on him. Yes, good. Yes, he got happy. Yes, he was sad earlier. Very good. Yes, and he became happy. So, yes, Vishesh, stand up. Now, the poet became happy. How did that change the poet's mood? How did it change him? How did it change? I'm not giving options. You have understood and you have enough options there. How did the falling of snow change the poet's mood? Fell on him. Then he said it's changed his mood. Then what happened? What did he do or what did he plan to do with the rest of the day? Was he going to sit and complain and feel sad? Or was he going to make the best of the remaining day, right? Yes, so he's not going to waste the day or waste the time that was left. Sit down. Yes, what kind of symbols are, yes, here, that is Krish. Stand up, please. He's trying to hide. Yeah. So what about these symbols here, the crow and the hemlock? Why are they negative? Why are they negative symbols? Why are they negative? What is negative about a tree? Hemlock tree is poisonous. Crow is, it's a associated with death. It's an omen of death. Hardik, when you keep quiet, then you will understand. And yes, here, yeah. Sit down. Yes, Gursimar, stand up, please. What does dust of snow mean? Yes, the shower of snow, the tiny particles of snow. Okay, very nice, right? Dhruv, stand up, please. What is the experience or how was this experience a changing phenomena for the poet? Okay, sit down. Yes, Jasmine. Can gifts of nature be negative? How? That makes them negative and we pass on our thoughts and idea till go from that side and yes, it is everybody starts believing it. Okay, right? So nature is always there teaching us lessons, and here also at a moment, sit down, when the poet thought that he's going through a very bad day, he's going through a very negative moment, immediately, yes, here we have these elements of nature coming and changing his perception, changing his viewpoint. Okay, right? Yes, Kartiki, come here. Mehul, stand up. I'm not giving you options. Can you tell me about the poem Fire and Ice? Stand up, please. Fire and Ice. Tell me about the poem Fire and Ice. What is it about? Oh, really? Yes, yes, sir.
In this poem, poet has told us about how the world is going to be end. It is going to be end in
either in fire or in ice. Okay. What, according to poet, is fire? What is a fire a metaphor for? Fire is for passion, yes, violence, aggression, lust, desires, right? And do you think this can bring an end to the world?
Yes. Yes.
So when we're too greedy, we have too many ambitions and too many desires, it can result in a lot of violence and, right? Yes, which would ultimately result in the end of the world, right? What do you think? Yes, Vishan, ice represents? Ice represents hatred. How? So ice is there. Like, yeah, you have a certain feelings in your heart, in your mind, but these are not necessarily visible, right? So fire is there about the passion with which you exhibit things. You're angry, you might get violent also. You might smash things, right? You are there, you're not happy there. And okay, fine, I'll go and teach that person a lesson. Or you send your troops to conquer another territory, isn't it? So that is there, a depiction of that fire that is there, of that passion that is there. When you talk about ice, they are those latent feelings there, the hidden, but yet expressed. What kind of feelings could they be, which are there? Maybe you could associate with ice, being insensitive, being cold-hearted, being jealous, yes, being envious of others, isn't it? So these are the feelings here. So when you are there, violent, we do imagine, yes, this will bring an end to the earth. Definitely here. But what about the ice? How can that bring an end? So hatred can, how can hatred bring an end? You're not showing that hatred. You are not on a rampage here, so violent with that hatred. So how is it going to bring an end? What happens when you turn or when you have these icy emotions? What ends in both the cases? What comes to an end in both the cases? Earth, and what is there? Can I talk about here? Can I say when I am violent, when I am icy cold with hatred and jealousy, what ends? Is it only the ending of people, or is it ending of much more than that? When you become insensitive, you're not worried or concerned about others, that will also be the end of the earth. Humanity, when it ends, when it ceases to exist, that is when the earth also ceases to exist. So earth is not about buildings and your skyscrapers or how many cars you have and the vehicles there, but it is the people who are there. And when those people, they stop being humans, that means it is the end of the earth, right? Along with the humanity on it, right? And of course, here, why are we talking about the end of the earth? Should the earth come to an end? Is it inevitable? What is inevitable, Shantanu? What does inevitable mean? Why are we laughing like this? Are we so amused that the teacher is asking us questions? We never answered questions before. Inevitable, which can't be predicted. Yes, Nishtha, what is inevitable? Yes, over there. Yes, Shahar, inevitable. Amritpal, Mehul, because nobody told you the answer, that's why. Yes, Hardik, what is inevitable? No, otherwise we are there depending on other sources, isn't it? Yes, Hardik, what is inevitable? What if this question comes here? What if this word is there in the question? What are you going to do? Prashant? Yes, Dhruv? We'll turn it dark in the circle, right? Yes, unattempted. Is it, Karthikeyan? Inevitable, yes, which cannot be avoided, right? So yes, here it is maybe inevitable. What is inevitable? The end of the world. That is why I'm saying, like, should this happen? Should the earth come to an end? No. And so how can it remain alive always? How can we keep it alive always? Being interdependent on each other, that will help. What is there? What is this fire and ice that we are talking about? What about it?
By not making that document.
Yes, by making sure that we realize not only the importance of earth, but by the importance of each other also. That yeah, we cannot survive alone. We need others to be here on this planet. And for that reason, we need to take good care of the planet. Who is the poet of fire and ice? Who is the poet of dust and snow? Okay. Who is the poet of tiger in the zoo? So we have Leslie Norris, right? Thank God. Otherwise, I was expecting the answer that all the poems have been written by Robert Frost. Yes or no? No. So, yeah, and what about the ball poem? Yes, very good, very good. Right, okay, yeah, yeah. And it's not John Cena, okay? Attendance, hardly any attendance I have here. 2, 28, 39. Take out your notebooks, write a few sentences, all of you. A few, yes. I am not giving you options. Take out your notebooks. Come on, lazy people. Come on, take out your notebooks. Let's start writing. Let's start writing. Write down and then I'll give you the options. Dipansh, start writing. Yes, at home, can you see? My mother dashed me 2 gifts so far. I shall get a job before this week. Dash. Right, third one. I'll give you the option, don't worry. Are we writing? Which OMR sheet is that? Okay. I think you're going to click a pick of your set A question paper and share it in the group. Set B student who has it, right? Make a PDF and share in the group. Where? Okay, then you share it in the group. A restaurant. Okay, first sentence. My mother dashed me two good gifts so far. Listen to the options now. One is, option is sent. S-E-N-T, sent. Second is has sent. Third is will send. And fourth is send. Time is there, no? So far has sent. Okay. Now, next one. Did you write the option? Correct one. I shall get a job before this week. Listen. Before this week, dash. End, ends, ending, will, ending, ends, ends, before this week ends, okay? Before this week ends, ends, the verb we have there, right? Before this week ends. You switch off your mobile phone during training session. Options are should, must, may, might. Okay. Yes, here. So should and must. What is the difference? Should is an obligation. Must is a compulsion. You must wear a helmet while driving, right? You should reach school on time. Okay? Haan, bilkul, yeah, but here there are some times when you have, right? You must come in proper school uniform, right? Okay? So, yeah, so you have should and must. Mr. and Mrs. Singh dash a restaurant where they work very hard. Okay, it's not have a restaurant here. Is it own? O-W-N. Is it own? Or owns? Owned or owning?
Owned.
Mr. and Mrs. Singh. Are we using it as one or two people? Two people, right? So what will come here? Own a restaurant. If it, I had said Mrs. Singh, then it would have been owns. Okay? Right. So let us do one more. After that, we're going to do reported speech. Amitpal, why are you not attentive in the class? What are you doing? Mehul cannot even write on a notebook. He doesn't have a page to write on. Right? Okay, you're doing it on that? Crazy you people are. Now, can I see your correct options? Show me. show me, and have you marked it properly? Is there any unattempted also? You've attempted all? Okay. Yeah. Fine. He's written in the box. So nice. This will be given to you pre-filled. Okay. And here is your question paper code. There's a hash also over there, right? Like 1, 4, say PQR. It could be like that. Fine. So take a look at this. This is where you have to write. You write this line only. I confirm that all particulars are correct. And this is your signature in running hand. Don't write over there in big capitals or something. Running hand as you put your signature. I did what I can. I did what I could. What can I do for you, sir? Please write down. Now, this is R is receptionist, T is the tourist, okay? I need a room. Write down, please. Write down. Let us finish this one. I need a room, preferably on the first floor, okay? Yeah. Let me see if the if the room is available. Correct. Next is the tourist is going to say simply two words. That is
thank you.
Okay, I am going to speak the blanks, write them down. The receptionist asked the tourist. The receptionist asked the tourist. Can you complete it? What she. Okay, fine, correct. What she could do for him. Next is. The tourist said that he, okay, replied that he needed a room. So when we are doing narration, we are not going to omit any information. So make sure all the information is there provided. We neither change or add. But we make sure that what is there, we will not omit it. Okay. Next is, let me see if the room is available. The receptionist what? Asked him?
Replied.
What? Told him?
Replied.
Told him, Aida?
Replied.
Okay. Okay. Replied to him. What? If the room was available. Okay, fine. Yes, yeah. And the tourist said thank you, or the tourist thanked her is also correct. Now, when I do interrogative sentences, yes, yeah, class. What are the things I need to remember when I change the sentence from the direct to the indirect? Yes, yeah. First things first.
Past tense.
Yes.
Past tense.
Tense will change.
Pronounce.
Pronounce will change. What about the time? right? Yes. And do I use that? No, I do not use that in interrogative. Naturally, we are doing this whole exercise from direct to indirect to remove that question mark. So when you rewrite the sentence, the question, and in your options, if there is a sentence, narration has been done, correct option is given. If the question mark is there, that option will be right or wrong. Because you have to remove that question mark. What do we change? We change the sentence into an assertive statement, right? So it can be a positive one, it could be a negative one. I remove the question mark. Do I use that instead? What am I going to use?
If or whether.
If or whether, and where I have my WH question. Okay. No, right, no. There's no change. So your who would remain that, and your what, when, where. Yes, how, right, all that, yeah, all would be the same, okay, right. One other sentence that you have to remember is your imperative sentence. So be very, very particular about these two sentences. One is your interrogative, second is your imperative. So remember I, okay? So what are the things you have to remember? Like she said, okay, let me find a room for you. Can you give me an example of an imperative sentence? What kind of sentences are imperatives? Yes, order, advice, command, suggestion, right? All that, it is an imperative sentence. Okay. The teacher said, students, open your books. Yes, that is an imperative sentence, right? And we did the right answer yesterday. What did you write, Hardik?
The captain ordered that soldiers to quiet.
Correct. Okay, so we have to remember, yes, depending on the kind of sentence, imperative sentence, and we write what? Open.